It's Danielle, and I am back with my week two of Project Life. So for this spread, I'm actually going to be using my Felicity Jane Susie kit. And this kit is so pretty. It's full of just pinks and sort of tealy, minty blues. And of course, the Felicity Jane signature black and white. And I absolutely love it. And I think that everything turned out super cute because of this fun kit. So I was really excited to use it. Now I have my photos printed out and ready to go, and there's just a few spots that needed some white cardstock, so I got that in place, and then I work on getting these cards in place. Now I pulled out the cards that I knew I wanted to use in this week's spread, and so I am just getting them organized in a good way. I'm spreading out the designs and the colors, and then of course certain cards would go with certain stories, so I get those in place. And then I pull out my title card. It's always the first card I work on each week. And I get the date stamped on there, or I should say the week number. I'm using this week number stamp just to indicate that it's week two. And then I am going to take my date stamp and mark out the dates. I pull out my little cheat sheet. This is just something I got off the internet. It shows what dates are in what week. And that way I don't have to look it up. I can just pull out my little list and cross it off as I complete them. And I'm also using a pretty bright pink. I thought it went well with the colors of this kit. And I do quite a bit of stamping in this spread, and I use that same ink for every stamp that I use. So I just pull out my first photo and a couple of cards that are going to go with this story, I guess. And I immediately pull out my Felicity Jane stamp because I know I want a stamp on that card that has that pink heart on it. I picked a stamp that says celebrate the little things, I think, and I am just trying to determine where I want to stamp that. I am deciding to be more brave with my stamping this year because I'm really kind of a chicken, but I decided to just kind of go for it here, and I do wish I had moved the stamp up a little bit, but it looks good, and I'm definitely happy with it, and I definitely wouldn't redo it, but I write my story on the card that says happy. I love that card. I think it's so cute. I was originally going to write my words on the sidewalk, and when I cropped this photo and printed it out, that was the idea I had in mind, but the story fits in this little happy card, and I decided the photo is still cute as it is, so it all works out. But this is just a picture of my daughter taking some mail to the mailbox. She got it's blank cards with envelope set from my brother and sister-in-law for Christmas, and she's been loving writing letters and taking them to the mailbox. It's super cute. She goes through phases where she likes to send mail, and our mailbox is just the next house over has the mailboxes in front of it, so it's super easy for her to do that, and so she enjoys that. Now, this second photo, I don't know. I debated whether I wanted to put it in there because it's a really goofy photo of me. I did not take it with the intent of putting it in Project Life. It's just a text that I was going to send my mom. I am constantly on the hunt for some fun reading glasses for her. I like to buy her fun and just different or reading glasses that I think are cool or whatever the situation is. But I found these floral ones at Staples, and I just put them on and snapped the selfie and sent it to her. But I thought it was kind of a funny way to kind of document that fun thing that I have with my mom. And so I decided to put it in, even though whenever I look at this spread, my eye immediately goes to that. And I think, why did I put that in there? So this next card that I'm working on, it says 2016, like you can see, and it's a black and white stripe. I really, really like it. And I noticed that the stamp set had the word focus, which is my one little word for this year. So I definitely had to use it. I really wanted to find a way to make it work where I kept the year on there because, you know, focus is my word for 2016, but It just didn't work out. It seemed like everywhere I tried to put that stamp, it just felt sort of awkward for me. So I just decided to punch a little circle out of some white cardstock and then stamp that word on the white cardstock. And I do like the way it turned out. I like the pop of pink against those black and white stripes, but I just kind of wish I could have kept the year on there too. To make this card a little bit more special, I decided to use some foam tape to pop up that circle that has my word on it, and it just almost even draws more attention to that special word. So next I pull out this picture of my pink bath, and I just took this one night because I found that I love taking a bath at night, especially on the weekends. It's just a nice way to relax, and I really enjoy it. But I usually will throw in like a bath bomb or something like that to make it a little bit more special. And I always love it when it turns the bath colors. And so this one was pink, which was super fun. So I just snapped this photo, but I had to use it because it matched so well with the cards that I was using. So I take this pink plaid card and I write something really quick, like a bath is the perfect way to end a day or something like that. And then I have this cute little bow from the cut apart sheet that I put below that. And I really love the way that turned out, just super sweet and fun. Now, this photo is a picture of my brother and my little girl. And my brother actually came over to watch football on Sunday. And the boys were watching football. But the next thing I know, they're on the floor with my daughter, helping her with her little hidden picture books. She has a few of these highlight books that just have hidden pictures in them. Like they're specialty books and they're super fun. But I go out there and find them all on the floor. Finding these pictures, it just made me laugh a whole bunch. And so I quickly jot down about that memory. And I love this picture. I think it's so sweet. I love that London gets to be close to her aunts and uncles, and that just makes me smile. So I definitely want to include those pictures when I get them. So now I pull out this picture of me holding some nail polish, and I, to be honest, I struggled a little bit with this card and I did cut out some of the steps because it took me a little bit to figure out what I wanted to do. Now, I absolutely love a tiny black dot pattern. I really love it. And so I took that card that had those little tiny dots and I cut just the dots off it. I'll probably save that flower section to use on a different project, but and then I layer an even smaller white piece of cardstock on top of that. And I quickly look through my stamps again. There was a stamp that says just go for or go for it. And I thought about using that because I'm just kind of documenting that you can never have enough nail polish. And my poor husband lives in a house with two girls that are super girly and love nail polish. So I know he thinks, oh my gosh, you how many blue nail polishes do you have, or how many pink nail polishes do you have? But there's never enough nail polish. So we had bought this color of green that I had been looking for, and so I documented that because me and my little girl are definitely obsessed with painting our nails right now, and we love it, and so I wanted to document that. I decided to pop this up with some foam tape as well, just to kind of repeat some of the techniques. It's just a good way to kind of bring everything together. So because I popped up that circle on the one side of my spread, I decided to pop up the square on the other side just to make everything balanced. And I used a star stamp from the stamp set just to add some pop of pink to that card. You can never go wrong with a pop of pink. Now, this card with the multicolored plus signs, I really, really like it. And this is the card that I was originally going to use to document the story of my brother and my daughter on the ground because the plus signs sort of mean together. And I was going to find some way to incorporate that story with this card, but I didn't end up doing that. So I decided to make this card just a pretty card. I always like there to be one or two cards that are just decorative and fun. I go through a few of the different embellishments that come in the kit, but I ultimately decide to just stick with this pink vellum heart, and then you'll see later how I stitch through it. So the story of this last card is that each month I want to do sort of a play on the Throwback Thursday theme. And so I'm going to pick a week each month to put in a photo of my daughter from her first year of life. And you don't see the photo here. You'll see it in the close-ups. And I did put it out when I was kind of laying out all the photos. But I just sort of talk about on this card how it's bittersweet to look back on the photos of her as a baby. On one hand, I'm super sad that she's not that little and that life is going by so very quickly. But on the other hand, I've seen how much she's grown, and that's exciting too. So, that's basically what I write on this card. So now I'm just showing you how I took several of the cards and I took them over to my sewing machine and I stitched on them. That's kind of my finishing touch each week to my Project Life spread. And now I'm just going to lay them all out and make sure that I like everything and that I don't need to add any other embellishment or things like that. But I just wanted to take this opportunity to say thank you so much for watching, and I would really encourage you to head on over to the Felicity Jane blog and check out what's going on over there. There's some super great projects. I will make sure to link to that down below. All right, hopefully we'll see you all very, very soon. All right, bye-bye, guys.